The West Coast became the centre of election campaigning today with visits from both the Labor and National leaders. Jacinda Ardern went to a hospital while Judith Collins was at a seafood factory. Political reporter Mikey Sherman on how voters received them.
Nothing says West Coast like a whitebait fritter. For Judith Collins, there was no shortage.
I love my West Coast whitebait.
The battle for the West Coast bringing both major leaders to town.
Hello! Welcome!
How you going?
Are you expecting to cross paths with Judith Collins today?
Oh, not necessarily. The West Coast is a big place.
But if they did bump into each other...
Nothing will happen if we do have contact with each other. Our force fields will not create any kind of explosion, so no one needs to worry.
Well, I would have said, hello, how are you? Hope you're having a nice day. And then I would have gone on to talking to the coasters, because I'm not going to learn anything from Jacinda Ardern. She's got nothing to teach me.
There was certainly no shortage of insults today.
Look, if Damien O'Connor and Jacinda Ardern don't care about the coasters, well, too bad for them, I do.
I'd say, in return, that there's quite a bit to fear about ACT at the National Party.
Mass immigration, is that her plan? Because I think she needs to front up.
The fight for the electorate clear.
Travelling from Greymouth to Hokitika today, we've already passed three Labor Party hoardings featuring Jacinda Ardern. All of them have been defaced with derogatory comments and pictures. Some of them I'm covering now for decency.
Those who are doing it are idiots and in fact, you know, not doing their cause. If their cause is opposing us, it's not doing their cause any good at all.
Speaking of hoardings, Maureen Pugh definitely wins on size.
Isn't it fabulous? It's wonderful.
In this electorate, National wins the party vote, but Labor has a 5,500 majority on the seat, National hoping to change that.
Why should people back you and not Damien O'Connor?
Because I've got the backing of a great team, the National Party.
Officially opening the Greymouth Hospital today. At the seafood factory, Judith Collins had a big fish story.
It's like a great big heavy. You're working against the water.
Leading to a job offer.
We'll look for a cup of deccan next week.
But it was job losses in mining National was keen to highlight. In fact, Labor says mining jobs dropped under National.
The number of jobs in mining is a smaller proportion of our total economy than it was, and that they dropped under National.
I actually think that nobody on the West Coast is silly enough to believe anything Damien O'Connor says on mining.
So what did voters make of the leaders in town?
I prefer Jacinda, by a long way.
Someone that will look after the people of New Zealand.
Have you decided who that is?
Not yet, really, no.
With a few more weeks to election day, there's plenty more time for politicians to convince voters.
And political reporter Mikey Sherman joins us now live from Hokitika. What do you make of the reception the major leaders got today, Mikey?
Yeah, look, a busy night here, obviously, in Hokitika. But, look, both major political leaders were well-received here on the West Coast. It's obviously going to be an interesting competition with National holding the party vote here, but Labor holding the electorate seat. So, look, today simply marks the end to a very big, big week for our politicians out on the campaign trail. Earlier this week, we had the One News Colmar Brunton poll and the One News Leaders debate, and here's an interesting and perhaps scary number for some politicians. There are now 7 days until voting begins, so the countdown now well and truly on.
Live from Hokitika, Mikey Sherman, thank you very much.